Yo, you know what it is, man. Hobby Kong guy. Each and every Tuesday night at 10 p.m. when you like me, there's that hip hop by live music for you.com. Look, it's the Angle Toys Live concert going here live, man. Everybody's tuned in. Sorry for the delay. Sitting here riding shotgun, man, as we do each and every Tuesday, man, with my co-host, Ernest L. from the world famous Go-Go Report.
What it do?
Also, look, ladies and gentlemen, on your camera right now, he's been MIA, but one thing about it, you know, he's been on a journey that the Lord has guided him through. My brother from another, when I was doing Metro World, man, this dude right here, we didn't miss a beat. We didn't miss a step, man. This dude right here is a legendary go-go lead talker.
Appreciate
a lot
that.
Of guys that took his style and ran with it. This guy is the one that won the Donnie Simpson brand new DJ contest out about what? About 7,000, 8,000, 9,000 people.
Yeah. Next Top Jock is what it was called.
Next Top Jock is what it was called.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
Put your hands together.
They're proud of me years later. This is great.
Put your hands together, man. My little brother Bootsy, man, he's battling.
What's up, man?
He's battling the Big C right now.
Oh, no, it's over, baby. So ain't no battling. One more keep on with it. It's a wrap.
Let him know again.
Yeah, so it's over. You know what I mean? Ain't no more. You know, the battle was in the beginning. It's all over now. So
I see the eyebrows and the mustache.
Absolutely, yeah.
I love you.
How you doing, man? First of all, thank you for inviting me. It's
good. Inviting you?
Yeah, man. First of all, it's good to see everybody in here. So I just want to say it's good to see everybody.
Oh, man.
I appreciate it. Somebody stole it. No, I ain't going to do that. Don't do that. I'm back.
Look, let me let y'all know something, man, about this dude right here. This dude right here, man, is a lot of people, you know, to say Heartbeat, you got the best show and this and that and that and this.
Well, you do have the best show.
Well, thank you for that.
Especially when I'm on it. But go ahead, continue. I like where you're going.
There we go.
I like where you're
going.
He's back!
I
like where you're going with this.
He's back!
The more I'm on it, the better you become. Keep going, keep going.
I love you.
Yeah, I just want to know where you're going with it. Go ahead.
Okay. Well, let me say this to you, man. When you raise somebody in this game, man, and they go on to become a legend in the game, not, you know, as far as only like lead talkers, but on the airwaves too.
Appreciate it.
Put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen, for the one and only, my little brother from another, man. I love you to death, man. Prayers are answered. Bootsy Vegas is
yes,
the
yes,
man.
Thank you.
Bootsy Vegas.
I love the whole studio audience thing too. You know, this is great. This is really great. And I also like your Redskin ensemble here. I'm a Redskin fan.
Right.
You know what I mean? I think, you know, you're taking it to another level. I can dig it, Ernest. You know what I mean?
Yeah, so, he's looking fly.
You like that right there?
I like it a lot.
And we got a guy that's making these for everybody.
Oh, what's up, man?
Yeah. I got a Go-Go Report coming, a Redskin jump, even though he's a San Francisco fan, but you're going to have to wear this jump, man.
Wow. The Go-Go, I'm in here, though. Eat life, me. This is great, though. Thank you again for inviting me. You know what I mean? I know there's a bunch of people in here, so I just want just say thank you, man, for allowing me to come here. It's good to see you.
You need to stop that.
It's good to see any and everybody, but it's really good to see you. And you know what I mean? And you always allow me to come in here and talk smack to you. You know what I mean? I come in and just make myself at home. So this is great. You know what I mean? You always been good for my self-esteem, too. I want you to know that. So just keep saying nice things about me.
Mm-hmm.
And keep emphasizing that you have the number one show when I'm on it. Just keep emphasizing that.
You
don't stop with that one.
Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, look. He's, as y'all can see, he's back.
Yeah. You know, Kimo ain't messed that up.
Ain't no stopping him.
My mind is sharper than ever now.
Oh.
Yeah, it's like, you know, it really
is sharper. It's always been. And for those that don't know, man, me and this dude right here, man, 101.3 James.
Charlottesville. Morningville Show. Rise and Grind Morning Show.
Me and the legendary Bootsy Vegas, man, have been like setting the whole VA on fire every morning with Sister Gertrude and the Bootsy Vegas. A Rise and Grind Morning
Shout out
to
everybody
man.
In Central Virginia. Call Pep, everybody
you
that's listening.
It, man. So, Boosie, man, let me stop. Little
bruh. What's up?
We talk all the time, but.
Yeah, we do.
Let everybody know, man, what's going on, baby. Bro.
Okay, so, Angel, first of all, you don't shed a tear, because if you shed a tear,
right.
I'm heading to the door. I ain't coming for this. I had to tell the Drummers Breakfast that same thing. No, but in July, early August, you know, I had popped the move. We was already, me and you was plotting on the fam junk, you know.
Right.
I was a reoccurring member on that junk. But I found out I was diagnosed with stage 4 lymphoma cancer.
Stage 4 lymphoma cancer.
Actually, late stage 4. I actually was diagnosed with late stage 4.
Because what happened was, me and my wife was on a speakerphone driving home. And I was talking to a little bruh. And he kept coughing and coughing and coughing. Really couldn't get a sentence out. Mm-hmm. And my wife was like, babe.
You did. I remember that.
What's going on? He needs to go get checked out.
You did. You did.
And he called me 2 days later, and I was the only one that knew.
Yeah, at that time, yeah.
Out of the whole movement. And when he told me, you know, he know how I am about him, man. It's like Rick or somebody, you know. So when oh, hold on. We're going to get to him later. Man, this. You know what, man? I can't do this show, man.
Everybody's in here today. You know what I mean? Everybody's
it's
in here.
Every week, though.
Yeah, but let me say this, because I know we're going to get sidetracked.
Hold on, let me finish.
Okay.
So when Bootsy talked to me and told me, you know, the situation, of course, it floored me. I broke down. It was devastating to me. But he told me, you know, to promise him, don't tell anybody yet. You know?
Yeah, because I didn't tell my family members at the time. So I was like, I got to start telling people, you know what I mean? But, you know, sometimes when you go through stuff, everybody, just because you're family, you're not necessarily family. And sometimes you got friends or mentors, like how you were, that are like family. So it was a different situation. But I just want to thank everybody that really prayed for me. And we talked about this earlier, about the power of prayer. The power of community prayer, too, you know what I mean? Because, you know, and I'm going to keep it short with this, you know what I mean? But I was basically diagnosed with the same thing BJ was diagnosed with.
Okay.
With the same thing, you know what I mean? And I had late stage 4. They told me to find out, prepared to go to a hospice. And, you know, they...
All right, whoa. Prepared to go where?
To a hospice. Yeah. I didn't tell everybody.
You didn't tell me that.
Yeah, I didn't tell everybody. But guess what? Once again, it's over. So basically, the power of prayer. So I instantly called Bill Lee and 2 other pastors that I was really cool with. We prayed. And just the power of prayer, they told me to find a hospice by the end of December. And now it's the end of December, and I have 0.3% cancer left, and it's over after my last jump. So, you know what I mean? So it's over, you know what I mean? It's over. But the power of prayer, the power of belief, you know what I mean, and just the mind of telling yourself that, you know, you don't want to go. So it's been a great journey. I've learned a lot about myself. I've learned a lot about who are really family members and who not. You know, we kind of had these conversations.
Yeah.
And the good thing is I get a, you know, I feel like I've been reborn, and I'm looking forward to the last chemo thing being over and then going on to the next thing. But I want to tell you this right now, okay? So I'm apologizing to you right now. I let Donnie know this. I let my sister know this too. Oh, January the 1st, you're going to see me act a fool on social media. So just ignore it. I'll be prepared for your phone call. I may go a little bit too far. I don't know what I'm going to do, but I'm going to celebrate on New Year's Eve. Please know this. So I'm apologizing early to you because you might be disappointed because I'm going to act a complete fool on New Year's Eve. I'm letting you know now, so I don't want to be no surprise to nobody. I let certain people who I know will call me and give me the info like you. So just know, I'm going to act a fool on New Year's Eve. Word to my mother. You better believe that.
I just want to say this to you, brother. My little brother, man. This dude has been my little brother, man, for decades, man. And
we still got work to do.
And he always tell me don't cry and all this. Because he know how much I love him.
Bro, I ain't coming. Let me tell you this.
I know. I ain't coming for this. You already told me that.
Yeah, we already
let me,
had
let me say this.
This
to
is
you,
a
man.
Celebration today, man.
Yeah, we celebrate.
Ain't no
we
time to cry now. It's over.
Okay.
We'll be crying
so,
for
so,
now.
So what we going to do, man, for real, man, is just uplift this show.
Absolutely.
But by you being here tonight, man, it's really made my night.
I appreciate it.
And you know how much I love you, man.
I appreciate that.
Now a big burden has been lifted off my back.
Absolutely.
Because, you know, worrying about you, of course, you know, I do my shows every week.
Mm-hmm.
I do what I do every week, you know. People, you know, yeah, beat you saving go-go and all this. That's fine and well. But at the same time, without my little brother right here, man, what y'all got to realize, before all this social media stuff what we got now, we did Metro World. We did Metro World, okay? Metro World was the first actual
go-go
platform.
MTV type of.
Hey, Donnie Ray. Thanks for the toys, baby. I love you, man. Don't go nowhere. Stay right there. But I want to say this to you, man. For real. From one big brother to a little brother, man.
Appreciate it.
I am so proud of you, brother.
Thank you, man.
Because not only on the lead talking situation, which you've changed lives doing that. What you've done in the radio business, winning that contest, in your professionalism, and your wittiness, man.
Also, please don't forget my good looks. Continue, though. I like when you're going with this. Don't forget that, you know what I mean, because looks count, but keep going.
I'll forget that one. But anyway.
It's hard to forget. I want to say, but thank you again, man, for even saying that I made your night, because I'm looking forward to making some females' night on New Year's Eve. So let's get this
all the way.
Let's get this out of the way. Let's hurry this up, bro. Come
Who
on,
got
man.
You started, man? Yeah, man. So you want to go there?
You did.
Okay.
Oh, how many times have I said that? Okay. A million times.
Okay. Anyway.
I don't even think I would have ever done it without you.
I appreciate that, man.
But we ain't going to have no somber moments in here, bro, because I already see where you're going with this. You ain't going to walk none of us down that somber road. So wrap it up, bro. Whatever you're going to say, all the nice good things you're going to say about me, wrap it up, bro, because I ain't going to let you get this.
In the words, I ain't going to go there, man. In the words of wrap it up, guess what?
What's that?
We got a lot of presents in here right now, man. For these unfortunate kids, man. It's a toy drive tonight, man. 8:10 p.m. each and every Tuesday night. EatLiveMedia.net, powered by LiveMusicForYou.com. It's a subliminal criminal keeping the middle of the dependable internet direction type of dude. Hobby Conga, man. Each and every Tuesday night, 8:10 p.m., man. Sitting here live, riding shotgun with Ernst Zell, Google Report. Bootsy Vegas, the legendary, is in the house.
Hey, what up, though?
I got my man Fish, man, from the job and everything. He came down here all the way from Nanjimoy.
Merle and down in the boonies.
Okay, let me ask you a question.
No streetlights.
Why is his name Fish, if you don't mind me asking? I you know what I mean? Sometimes
I want to know that. What's up, little Dirty?
Hey.
Why's your name Fish? He's
the reason why it came that way was the goatee came out pieces at a time and was originally Catfish, so they just dropped
what?
The name Fish.
Mm. So you had a coat, you had a Catfish goatee?
Exactly.
You believe in Myrna Sam?
Hey.
Yeah,
that's a true story.
Oh wow! So that's why they call you Fish.
That's how they call me.
So why don't they call you Catfish then?
It just dropped out. I guess I grew Catfish.
So it has nothing to do with Abe Pagoda.
No, it doesn't have to do with Abe Pagoda.
Okay. Anyway, y'all, like a look. We got Ernest L. riding shotgun each and every week. Ernest L., what it do, baby?
Hey, same old same, man. Having a good time.
How you feeling, man?
Enjoying go-go, man. I'm good, man.
Man, you had a rough weekend, man. You had a rough weekend.
Why is that? Please tell me everybody.
We call him the helicopter for one reason. He's at like four or five go-go's a night.
That's what's up.
And for those that don't come to Go-Go's, you know, damn, I remember back in the day, you know, abandoning them used to crank out.
Hey, go this to Facebook. Weekend coming up, man, y'all really need to come out, man.
What's coming up?
Friday, you know, we got Listen.
Oh, wow.
Listen to Faith Evans.
Listen. Listen's playing it. They are?
Yeah, man.
Let me ask you a question. So is that like a reunion? I ain't being funny. I just want to know what it is.
Nah, it ain't really.
Are you in the card, E? Are you in the card?
Well, here's the thing. They've had 6 reunions and never invited me to one, you know what I mean?
I don't understand.
But the good thing is, the publishing checks that I get from the 3 albums that I'm on, I still like it. You know what I mean? I just want to know. I ain't know what it was, though. You know what I mean? So, you know what I mean? So.
Yeah, this Friday.
So, hold it! From E.
Mm-hmm.
And you're on over
here. Yeah, man. This Friday up to Howard, man. Yeah. Faith Evans, too.
Well, let me say this to Listen, man. Scooby, I know y'all listening, man.
Shout out to Scooby. Let me say this.
Why? Hold on.
Before you start, because I'm going to tell. I want to thank everybody in both OP Tribe and Listen, and especially Scooby, for supporting me during my chemo.
Okay.
They have placed phone calls. They always checked in. Now you can go.
Okay, now all I want to know is, like, you know, all these reunions. Why haven't E been part of any reunion?
That's a great question, man. That's a great question.
To me, like, when I hear you, hold it, that's E all the way, bruh. I got Metro World clips, man, from back in what year?
Hey, man, let me say this, though. I know now, if I ain't invited to this one, after all this I ain't never going to get invited. Like, if I don't get this, let me know. For me,
I don't understand it, man.
Just let me know. For me, I ain't got no shot.
I'm gonna call Dink, man. Do I have to call Dink?
Hey, just let me know. I ain't got no shot there. If I can't
call nobody, because
it's all good.
It's back from 90 what?
Yeah, no. I appreciate him saying this. I appreciate it. We just having satire conversation. Word. You know what I mean? And I'm tired of people asking me about it. I ain't gonna lie. I am tired of people asking me about it. Why? You know, after 3-4 years, people get asked you the same question when it come up, and you gotta address it. You know what I mean? And I always say, man, y'all need to ask them. You know what I mean? So, but I know this one, though. If I'm not invited after all this I done been through the last 6 months, I know it ain't no shot for me yet. I ain't never going to get invited.
Word.
Like, any glimmer I thought,
bruh.
You know, you always hold on.
I know, bruh.
I know now, man. This is.
I was thinking of a joint the other day on YouTube, man, from the Unifest.
Okay, yeah.
OB Tribe. Scooby right next to you with the guitar and everything.
Yeah. Shout out to him again. Thank you for
supporting me. Y'all was cranking so hard.
Thank
man.
You for supporting me during the chemo.
What was that dance that you was doing?
You know, I stay dancing, you know what I mean?
What was the name of that dance, though, man?
I mean, I don't even think we ever really had a name for it. It was just something, it was never, you know what I mean?
Because I made up a name for that name.
You did?
Uh-huh.
Wow. You a couple of years too late. But enlighten the listeners.
It was called the Freaky Deep.
Freaky Deep. Hot Beat. Was somehow your name always gets in it, but go ahead, though.
Exactly.
I like where you're going
freaky
with it.
Freaky Deep, it's Hobby Conga. I had to put the Freaky Deep in there, man, because you lost your mind. You lost your mind, man.
Yeah, and I got it back now. How about it? Hey, so hold on. So is some other big shows coming this week, or that was the big one that you were talking about?
That's just the kickoff. Yeah, mm-hmm. That's Friday. Mm-hmm. Then Saturday, the Metro Boys, Frank White, Christmas Party, Kendrick Soul Family, and Team Familiar, Belladonna.
Black Alley playing on that too, right?
Okay, let me ask you a question, Ernest. Mm-hmm. So who are the other bands this weekend? Like the Metro Attractions and the Prime Times and the Change of Faces and the
Change of Faces be rocking a wild every Friday, sir. You know,
what's JYB doing this weekend?
Oh, JYB down Nipsey. You know how JYB get down. Yeah, as far as I know, JB.
So your top 10, okay, now.
I love it because he's on the spot. Top, like, you can't stop him.
He put the top 10 out last week, man, and it was very controversial because we had my man Super Dan. Super Dan actually hit me on the inbox. Was like, you know, gotta see him 3 times. LOL. With the, you know, WTF. I didn't respond.
Oh, he went there? I ain't know he went there.
I didn't respond, but I'm putting
it. Oh, okay. Hey, hold on. Let's address that right now.
Go ahead.
Hold on. Now, what he say? What he got to say?
He said, this is what he said, and I'm saying it in front of you and him, you know, I'll leave it alone. He said, 3 bands, you got to see them 3 times. LOL.
He don't know. He a DJ. I'm in the battlefield with this.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Shout out to my man Super Dan. But yeah, 3 times. You gotta go see the band 3 times. You gotta go see a band 3 times. You can't juggle them on one performance. I don't do that. Give them 3 shots, you know what I'm saying? 3 strikes, you out. know what I'm saying? Best out of three. Okay. You know what I'm saying? Because you can go see a band one night and they crank, then you go see them again and they slumming. Okay. Yeah, so nah, three times. You know what I'm saying? That's how it is, Superman, you know.
Makes sense.
Yeah. Okay, man, 8:10 p.m., man, look. 8:10, hold on, Boosie. 8:10 p.m. each and every Tuesday, man. I got to advertise the network, EliMedia.net, powered by EliMusicForYou.com. I want to pick up Andre Durfee. Come on over here, little bro.
Uh-oh.
Come on over here. Huh? What happened to you, man? Out there on the court again.
I'm here. Trying to buy two new knees.
Hey, is it me or let me ask a question before you even get to the mic. Come on over to the mic, though. Is it me or do he like Scarface? He probably get that every day, though, right?
Oh, he looks like Tanky Jones.
Nah, he like Scarface.
Dre a man of many looks.
And Bones, look, we got my other cousin, the legendary Bones in here from with the Wisdom Speaks shirt on. But from the legendary class band. Hey, Bones! Well, all right. What up, little bro? What it do, man?
Man, it's just another day in the neighborhood, baby. Everything is love. Love you more, man. You know the deal. I just like to check in and you show love, man. We, wife and I came through, wanted to support the
Toys
for Tots and everything.
Come on over here. Look, you got them Dynamite cupcakes? Last time she had these cupcakes up here, man.
Those are Ciroc joints right there. Those not the what was that other one she had? The rum chowder. Those are Ciroc joints right there.
Wifey made me a birthday cake. Everybody that was chiming on that birthday cake, wifey made them joints, man. And dog, like these cupcakes she got right now are, this was a legendary episode because everybody ate them cupcakes, bruh. You squeeze a little straw joint and it shoots a Ciroc in them. And everybody left here like, and got DWI off a cupcake.
Wow.
I apologize to everybody. So it's, you know, eat at your own risk. That's on y'all. Eat at your own risk, man. It's a hobby con guy. Now, a lot of people looking at the shirt right now. This is another sponsor, man. This guy made me shirts and jackets and all kind of stuff, man. So the whole staff is getting them. I know you're not a Redskin fan, but you're getting one. You have to wear it.
That should be. That should actually have to be a requirement to be on your show, though. It's your show.
That's right.
Yeah, you know what I mean. So, you know, you gotta be a part of the team. You know, team stands for together. Everyone achieves more. So you gotta roll with it. You gotta roll with it.
Yeah, but he does have a Red Wings hat on, and he's a San Fran team.
I know. I wear it all though.
Yeah, but the Red Wings are hockey.
But the flies dude in go-go, so I can't even go there with him. Nah. I'm sorry.
That's that man.
Let me back. I'm sorry. You ain't not the flyest dude in go-go. The flyest dude in go-go just came up in this job, man. Hey, Bounce. He more fly than you?
Man.
He more fly than you?
I
don't know about that. Me and Go-Go Mickey, snap that jump. You are the flies, bro.
Hey, Mouse is the flies.
Man, look.
So we got a flies contest in there.
We got a flies contest. And we got a house pack, you know, right now. But everybody, you know, and more people are on the way, man. So y'all know how we do, man. We even got, this dude just walked in. Yeah, I'm talking about you. He's back here again, man. And this dude is, it's Chuck Brown, it's Max Kidd, and put your hands together for Kenny Bombs.
Kenny!
Out of these three magnificent individuals, man, if it wasn't for, you know, these three individuals, it wouldn't be no Go-Go. Okay? So, and the reason why we're here tonight is because of Go-Go. Because this is the Hobby Conga Eye, and the reason why we get 40,000 views worldwide a week, and a lot of people don't, y'all don't get on 40,000. I had to show two people.
Man, you know how haters do, man.
You know.
Hate.
The evidence, you know, which I shouldn't have had, you know, somebody tell me, why'd you do that? Why you, don't let me know your, I had to show them. It's not, you know, I don't have to, like, tell you how many viewers I get. I just know what we get. Anyway, put your hands together for the legendary Mr. Kenny Bombs is in the building again.
Thank you.
Looking fresh like Dougie, as he always does.
Bought you a couple toys too.
Hey, sir. But you know you on here next week.
I know.
What, you gonna be a co-host, man? We like to throw the red carpet off of you, man. You know, you ain't no pop up joint. You know what I mean? You one of them, you know, you a treasure, bro.
You invited me to the Christmas party.
Of course.
Yeah, so I had to be here.
And it's a gift.
Yeah, I had to be here.
I see the bow on your head right now. Who's the beautiful young lady you have with you right now?
That's a friend of mine.
That's a friend of yours?
Yes, her name is Penny.
Penny? Hey, Miss Penny. Hello. How you doing, baby? Looking so elegant. Looking like fine wine. Very beautiful. We got Sakina out here, man. Sakina from Blaze Band. We got Donnie and Will. Everybody just pouring in, man. Donnie Ray, come on over here, man. With Donnie Ray.
Donnie! Yes.
Put your hands together, Donnie Ray, man.
Donnie Ray, man.
Because, like y'all know how they... And Bone. My co-host Bone's over there, too. He laying in the back, chilling. The big picture. No. Not you. Other Bone. This first time in history, we got two Bones in the same building ready.
Hey, we're L.
Donnie Ray. Hey, baby.
Hey, I'm feeling good, man. I'm feeling good.
Let me say this to you, man. Thank you for, you know, dropping the toys off and all that.
Yes, sir.
But let me say a little bit about you.
I appreciate it.
Donnie Ray is one of the most prestigious singers in the gold community.
Thank you, sir.
EU.
Band of Brothers. Band Black of Brothers. Tracks, Red Form. I've been around the charts a little bit.
Yeah, man. And just let me, like me and Donnie Ray, man, that's my brother from another, man. This is my dude right here. Heart of gold, man. Would do anything for you. Take the shirt off his back for you. Great dude right here. One of the most talented singers out here in the gold community, man.
Well, let me say something about you, man. I think it's awesome that you having a toy drive, first of all. You know what I mean? Wow. Just to give back to the kids, man. I love what you do for the go-go community. Whenever you need me, man, call me, Facebook me, instant message, whatever it takes. Send a bird over there, a pigeon or something with a note, man. Call me. I'm on the way for you, champ. And that's
you,
my
man.
Word, man, as a brother. You feel me?
I love you, brother.
You feel me?
Yes,
this
sir.
Dude right here, Ernest L, too. And I just told Bones, man, just a second ago, man, I really like you, man. Good dude, man. You surround yourself with good dudes, man. So
you like him?
If you, man, Bone, man, I love that dude, man. Good dude. I mean, it tell you what
That's
type of person you
right
are.
There. That's the big picture.
It tell you what type of person you are by the dudes that surrounding you. Because if you surrounded with good dudes, that means you got to be a good dude. Because good dudes don't like bad dudes. Don't nobody want to be around Obama. You feel me?
Word.
A suck old B-made type of dude. You know what I mean? And like I told you in the message yesterday, man, not to put all my business in the street, though, but I learned a lot about men down Lawton. I mean, you know what I'm saying? It was a proving ground for me. And I learned a real dude from a bad dude. And you a real dude.
Thank you, man.
For that, I got a lot of respect for you. So like I said, whenever you need me, I'm here. Got to get up at the crack of dawn for work, so I'm out. I hope the kids enjoy the toys, man. I hope everybody in the whole go-go community, all y'all, come down here and support this, man. We blessed to be able to do what we do. We get paid money to sing and smack on congos and cowbells and shake tambourines, man. And that's a blessing, man. And if you don't know it's a blessing, I'm telling it to you now, because when I was away from the scene, I was miserable. So now that I'm back, man, I'm going to get back every time I get a chance, man, because I know how blessed I am just to get paid, just to get a dollar to sing a song, man. I've been singing all my life. And somebody pay me? Man, God is good. You hear me? God is good, man. Peace and love, everybody.
Hey, Donnie Ray. I love you, man. Thank you, man.
That was really good, Donnie. That was. Yeah, man.
Man, let him know, man.
You sound like Donkey.
One more time, man. One more time for Donnie Ray, man. One more time, y'all, for Donnie Ray, man.
That was pretty powerful. You know what I mean?
That's what it is, man. With this show, man. I don't know what it is. That's why somebody. I ain't gonna say who, but I'll say it. Go Mickey. Look at me call this joint the Haynes Point of Go-Go.
That's funny. That is funny.
The Haynes Point of Go-Go.
That is
because
funny.
What it is, and the reason, it took me a while to understand it, but what it is, you got legends parked outside the show.
It's funny. That's funny, man.
You know, that's not funny. That's real, bro.
Nah, I'm talking about the Haynes Point of Go-Go, bro.
Yeah.
That's really funny, though.
Think about Haynes Point.
I know.
Right.
Yeah. That used to be the ultimate hangout.
Yeah, the hangout, man. And everybody's here all the time, man.
People lost their virginity down here.
And it's not just, not put nobody down, but ordinary people. Just like legends. Look around the room, man. Everybody in here is somebody that done did something to contribute to this this escapade we call Go-Go, man. Yeah, man. That's what it is. We don't need no commercial breaks. Sorry for tomorrow, my sponsors and all that, but right now, we just rolling with the flow. You got Go-Go bouncing up in here. Where your son at, man?
He under the weather.
Okay. Good. Let me bring my cousin over here, man. The legendary Bones, man. The original Bones.
Bones, man.
Class, man. Put your hands together, Bones. Man. This is the original.
Word.
This is the original Bones. I've been trying to get me down. Now, ladies and gentlemen, everybody said he got cousins and all that.
Sam,
this
hey, see,
this is my family.
My man's in them.
Yeah.
Hey, my you go family. Way back.
Why are you telling me, though? Like, I don't know. Anyway, this is my cousin, man, Bones, man, a.k.a. Orlando. Boogity butt, bang, bang the bone. The legendary class band. Cousin, how many times have I asked you a black ass to come up here on the show?
It's been like a million times.
Now, you know your uncle turned 78.
I know. I said happy B-Day to him. You know what I'm saying?
You call him?
Nah, you got to give me the number. I ain't got his number.
I ain't have a new number either. I ain't going to give
him. You know, him but see, I'm his chauffeur, but he ain't even called me.
Well,
I'm anyway. His chauffeur.
What's up, cuzzo?
Nothing much.
Just, how you feel, man?
I'm feeling great. I'm blessed, man.
You look
man.
Good, baby.
Thank you.
Love
man.
You, man.
Appreciate you. Love you, too.
You're my cousin, man.
Yes, sir.
Huh?
Hey, Slim, they don't know how this blood is right here, boy. They
this
just
a
don't
mean
know.
Bloodline.
Hey, is it?
Mean.
Yeah.
Mean, man.
Yeah.
So, just let everybody know, man, what you been doing, man, what you up to. You are the legend. Buggity, butt, butt, bang. Let me start with this. Now, that's my
a cue. Legend?
No, that's my cue. I'm not shy. I'm the big brother Bones from the Maryland side. I'm a freaky dig horn like the rest of the crew. If you do it to me,
I'll sock it to you.
Now, don't forget, I want to be known. Boogity, butt, butt, bang, bang, the butt. What you know about that? Yeah, he's from Fourthville, too. I forgot. I'm just from everywhere. Anyway, it's the boogity, butt, butt, bang, bang, the Bones, man. What's up, Bones? What's up with the class band reunion, man?
I'm about to show you. Somebody just sent me a picture.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Check that one out.
I like that shirt too. That's another Bones experience.
Check that right there out.
Wow.
Check that out.
Hey, that's bad.
The reunion part two, huh?
Yeah.
The reunion part two. So it is coming up.
It's coming.
So do I have to turn that joint out again?
You say turn it out.
Do I have to turn that joint out again?
They don't know what you did.
It's all on YouTube.
Hey, oh yeah.
Huh?
You and Hot Sauce.
Me and Hot Sauce?
My goodness.
Yeah,
sir. Clap your hands.
Slick Daddy Rick just walked in, man. Your cousin?
Yep.
Your cousin. So let everybody know what's going on with the reunion, man. What's happening?
They putting it together. We getting it together.
Y'all rehearsing yet?
Yeah, we started rehearsing. Section rehearsing and stuff. Okay. So we putting it together.
All the old hits?
I really don't know the song list yet, so... All you could do is just go and request. Request your old. You got it.
It's all the originals gonna be there.
Hopefully, everybody that played with Class Man come back.
All right, let's talk about Wisdom Speaks right now. What's going on with Wisdom Speaks?
Oh yeah, man, I'm loving that, man. I'm just having fun with Wisdom Speaks, man. It's the band that you heard about.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay,
yes, sir.
I think you're a very good asset to that band because one thing about Bones, man, and we got come on over here, to other Bones. Come on over here. Let's make history right now.
Yes,
because this is the Bones, and this is the other Bones. When you can get two Bones together at one time, and both of them are legendary, we're going to make history right now. This is the other Bones right here. And when people say Bones, they're like, who are you talking about? Which one are you talking about? Which Bones are you talking about? You got two Bones in Go-Go, okay? You got Bones, and then you got Bones. You got Bones, and you got Bones. And it's so funny. Raise that mic up to other Bones, man. Now, ladies and gentlemen, this dude right here, you know, a.k.a. The Big Picture, makes the best shirts in Go-Go, number one.
Hats,
number two,
jackets.
The best jackets, hats, puts on the best videos. This dude is taking Go-Go to another level when it comes to, like, having your shit on video. He makes it like a movie. He has the credits up like it's a motion picture and all that, man.
Thank you, bro.
Put your hands together for him. Not only... the baddest dude out here in Go-Go as far as the t-shirts and the motion pictures and the hats and all that.
Word.
But happens to be one of my co-hosts, even though he's been A-W-O-L for the last 2 weeks. Because I know one thing about him, you know, that man works. He does a whole lot of things. So
thank you, bro.
Whenever he pops in, man, it's a privilege. Put your hands together for the legendary Bone Simmons, man. He's in
the
building. Thank you, bro. Appreciate you.
In the building.
My man.
I'm looking right now, though. Okay.
Bone.
Now, a certain individual like doesn't really get excited over my gear. Okay. My wife. Anyway, dude came to my house and dropped me off a junk for my birthday, man. And I got like a million compliments off this joint, man. Mick seen the junk. Y'all seen the picture with me and Mick.
Yeah.
I wore that junk, man. Mick seen that junk was like, you know, Mick scratch his head. Mick always scratch his head for his next thing. Damn, y'all. That junk tight. I'm like, yeah, so I'll check that junk out. You see the hearts, then the beat.
Then the beat, right? Baby.
He ain't put heart beat. He put the heart.
Then the beat.
Then the beat. Right? And now, he never ceases to amaze me. Because now, I'm looking at Bone's shirt, right? And I'm kind of, you know, I get jealous every time I see something else, right? Now, I'm looking at this fool's jacket. No, not your shirt no more. We done with that. I'm looking at his jacket right now. I'm looking at my Redskin jump. I'm going to take this off, you know, just, you know. Don't do that.
You want to see the wings flying in the back? You want to see how the wisdom will speak?
There it go.
You know you wrong,
bro. The wings flying in the back, baby. Yeah,
man, before we start this interview with you, I don't even know why I'm interviewing him. He's supposed to be sitting down anyway. Look, bro. Can I get a heartbeat jump with the back and all like that, man? Give me one. I buy the jacket. Let's put the print on there, man. What do you do, man? I'm going to start calling you the Liberace of Go-Go. Because you got that bling, bling, bling.
I want you to stand out when the lights hit you.
The lights ain't even hit you. You're standing out.
I want you to stand out. You see Bone.
The band that you heard.
Bones and bones, baby. Bones and bones, baby. Yeah. What's up, little bruh?
Hey, no, baby. What's cool? Give me some, baby.
I love you, man. Hey, look. I love you too, baby. Why can't they give you something, you know, when you supposed to be sitting down? This is your show, too.
Oh, man, I appreciate you, bro. Oh,
man, good to see you, man.
Good to see you, too.
Don't miss another week.
Can I just say one thing?
Go ahead.
Man, I didn't even know it. Me and him as childhood friends. We had the same best childhood friends, and we didn't even remember each other when we saw each other. Yeah. Years later.
And both of y'all named Bone.
From Southeast, from the same neighborhood.
Bone.
Yeah, and both of us named Bone.
It's only been two Bones and Go-Go. And that's great. And both of y'all my family. Put your hands together for Bones and Bones, man. We got to go Bones and Bones album or something, Slim. Forget Bones, Thugs and Harmony. We going to go Bones and Bones. You don't stand me. But good to see you back in the place, man. Home, man. Good to see you, man. And I got to commend you, man, because what you've been doing for the community is it's just extravagant to me, brother. For the time and work and your work ethic and the time and patience that you put in, man, to give us good quality. Yeah. Anybody can go to a show and just record, but what you do, man, you make it a motion picture.
Right, right.
What it actually is, man.
First you gotta have
give them that mic.
A good staff is what we doing? You done?
We're behind.
Yeah. Well, your brother, he's definitely good people to deal with. Far as in this go-go game, you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
Because I'm talking about everything is always right when I'm dealing with them.
Right.
You know, so that makes it easy.
Right.
It makes me really put my heart into when I'm doing anything for him. I mean, he gots me up endless hours editing something for him because I don't want his editing to look like the next person's edit.
Right.
You know, so I want to give him something entirely different.
Yeah, man. And I just want to say to you, man, just letting everybody know, man, I got a bomb squad over here, man. I got Lonnie Love, Ernest L, Bones, the Big Pitcher. We got the bomb squad, man. All these other shows, man, I love y'all to death, but this joint right here, man, we got
it's
the bomb.
Over other shows.
This is the bomb squad, man. We got these fools over here, man. These are fools, man. Then we got my 14, I don't know, 15. Think about DJ, man. He's supposed to be in the bed right now. He's entertaining you guys, man. Entertaining you guys, bro. So that's what it is, man. Hoppy Kong guy. I mean, we're going to take a crank break for like 3 minutes. Let man get his man on.
Can I plug a shout out?
Quick plug. Bones, do what you want to do, man, because you ain't been on here yet. Go ahead.
Hey, big ups to my young HD Wilson Warriors on that hardwood. They took them Rough Riders out last night, 83-58. And Young ain't doing it. Big ups to Derquan. He scored 35 last night, and Keo Boy, number one in the nation in 2009 class, put up 29 buggers. Got them rough ride with five players.
I thought you going to say something about Wisdom Speaks to somebody. You talking about high school basketball.
The band that you heard about.
I love that shirt though, man. Same. Anyway, man, look, it's Hobby Conga. Each and every Tuesday night, 6 p.m. your money like me. This that nip by Larry for news.com. I am a subliminal criminal, keeping the minimal, dependable, and the direction of the nice sex sniper and complexion and social protection. Sitting here riding shotgun, my main man Fish, Ernest L, Bones, other Bones, DJ Main, my main man Rolling Grounds, man. We got my man Kenny Bones in the building. Let's go. 2 minute break. You should have never let me in. Y'all ladies in trouble. You should have never let me in. Y'all ladies in trouble. You should have never let me in. Y'all ladies in trouble. You should have never let me in.
Y'all ladies in trouble. You should have never let me in. Y'all ladies in trouble. You should have never let me in. Y'all ladies in trouble. You should have never let me in.
Yo, I'm the center of attention when I walk in the club. The eunuchs in the socks, chickens all in the club. Be on the rocks in the bottom of the club. On these security, this gorilla's enough. I came to ball with y'all, bow to ball with y'all. So ladies, call your friends, brothers, call your bros. Your girls are tits.
Everybody drink the wine. All my neighbors, Big Brother Tyrone. And Palmer Park. Everybody from Palmer Park. Yeah, where are you, baby? Brother Sydney from Palmer Park. What's up, Sid? Big Brother Sid. Cute young lady here with the bedroom eye. What's up, Joanne? Big Brother Chris behind the bar and she is.
Hey,
Yeah, man. Hobby Conga, each and every Tuesday night, 8, 10 p.m. We here at the Toy Drive, man. Everybody's in here. Go-Go Bounce is in here. My man Fisher here. Bones is in here. Ernest Hell in here playing the Congos. DJ Rick on the 1 and 2s, man. Ula Tony just walked in. This guy off the plane. We got Kenny Bonds in here, man. Beautiful young lady with him. We got Slick Daddy Rick in here. We got Donnell Wells in here, man. We got Rolling Grimes here on the 1 and 2s. Then we got Andre Durfee in here with the beautiful wife. We got Bones. Other Bones in here. Bones, Simmons, Bones, Brown. We got everybody in here. People still coming in, man. DJ Manes on the 1 and 2s. DJ Slick Rick. I'm calling him Slick Rick because that's how I feel about him. On the ones and twos too, Rick. Give me that. Give me some more of that, man. Give me some more of that, Rick. Let him know, man. And a lot of y'all promoters are sleeping on my brother right here. This dude right here did two cabarets this last weekend. for the Home Depot jump, the Dunbar alumni jump, turn both of them jumps out. Nut, everybody listening, this is the dude y'all want, man. He gonna turn your party out. Never Seen is amazing. Let's do it, Rick. Let's get it, Rick. Let's get it, Rick. Let's get it. This is DJ Main's mentor right here. Hey, Rick, let's get it, man. Let's get it, man. Let's go. Promoters right here, look. Promoters, everybody, look. Hi, my man, man. DJ Rick, man. Hey, what's that number, Rick? 202-390-1151. That's 202-390-1151, man. DJ Rick, man. Hi there, man. Put it on Google Report. Hold on. 202-390-1151, man. DJ Rick, man. Hi for your party. All you promoters out here right now, a lot of parties that come to, man, these DJs suck. Harlem, my man. I'm serious. They really do. People sitting down and all that. This man get the party moving, man. It's Nerd Tuesday night, man. Hobby Con guy. You like me to done that power by livemusic4u.com. Ron Shotgun with my co-host Ernest L here from the Go-Go Report. We got my main man, Ula. What up, man? What it do, man? Come on right here, man. Ula Tony's in the building, man. He just got an airplane, man. The legendary Ula Tony, man. Curtis Blow, party time. Congo play from EU. Look. Party time, ooh la la la, all that. The legendary man is in the building. What's up, big bro? Hold on, say that again.
Trying to get some things together for 2017.
Okay.
In the studio, getting some things. You know, my band, Haru Music Experience, is about to do some.
Doing
things.
A swell job to
my man. You know, we trying to take it to the next level, like you said. We trying to be the Beltway Band.
Oh, man.
You know.
Yeah, them 495s be killing me, man.
Yeah, you know, just doing that. We knock what they do, man. We give our city what they love.
The reason why I'm knocking certain individuals is because they 495 is acting like they're international.
Mm-hmm.
So what you got to do is humble yourself.
Yeah.
And realize that, look, you're on 495. Okay, you're on certain clubs in the Beltway. It's Beltway.
Right, exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
I've been jet set since 87.
Do that.
Jet
do
set.
That. Yeah.
And I'm as humble as you can be.
Yeah.
So don't get a big head playing in Suitland and Glen Arden and Northwest, Northeast.
Right.
You know, 78 countries in me. Oprah Winfrey, Arsenio Hall, Jay Leno.
Do that.
Letterman, all
do
that. Did that, done that.
That's
so don't get a big head playing in martinis or some other club, okay?
Exactly.
You ain't did shit yet.
You know.
It's good to play home.
Get your money. You're
not putting down on clubs and like
gotta
that.
Eat.
You know what I'm saying?
Gotta eat.
But at the same time, stay humble, man. We can grow as a business, you know what I mean? And big up to my man Kenny Buster Move, man Joe Jackson with Martinis right now. Mm-hmm. Martinis right now, bro. I went to celebrate my birthday, like, 2 weeks ago there,
right.
One of my birthday celebrations.
Right.
Martinis, like Kenny Buster Move and them, they really got this jumping right now.
Oh yeah.
Them and Joe and all them, okay. Prime Time, RB and all. They got Martinis right now to another level.
Okay, that's good to hear.
It's going to another level with them, man. You know?
Yeah, because it, yeah, for when it was, lasted. It's been some years. It looked like it was slipping off there.
No, sometimes you got to bring in a new. I would hope.
Okay. Okay.
But let's get back to you, man.
Uh huh.
Last time I seen you, man, I was on Facebook. You know, you were on your flight to somewhere.
Yeah, I was on my flight to Cleveland, the house. But we trying to, you know, the band itself. We, you know, the bigger picture. You know, the real bigger picture of things. You know, record. You know, if you hear any of our recordings, you would know that we keeping that home flavor with an international sound.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And then we following the blueprint, man. Chuck put down the blueprint.
Pop did, man. Pop.
Everybody.
Pop, like, man. Pop told me, man.
Yeah.
Front of time.
Yeah.
Me and Pop was chilling.
Yeah.
In my bedroom. Like we would always do, and he would always go out, be 2 a.m. Pop would always give me a word of knowledge, you know. My parents lived in 708,
mm-hmm.
but me and Pop being my apartment 110.
Right.
So we'd come from my bed eating dinner. Me and Pop always came downstairs, right? Me and Pop came always, you know, we always come downstairs and be like, you know, Pop, what you got to say to me?
Well, son,
beating
of the mind. I just want you to just keep doing what you're doing. So, I'm going to go in here now and go to bed, man. But, don't make too much noise. I know you were about to bring the hooligans in here. I know y'all do, son.
But, your own apartment.
My own apartment, right?
I know what y'all do, son. But wait, Pop, you know, wait for a minute. Let Pop fall to sleep first. Y'all wake me up. I'm going to come out there.
Yeah.
We ain't going, you know, do y'all thing, whatever, you know, do that pop pop. Mm-hmm.
Y'all ever have any arguments or disagreements, like,
me and
in music? Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. You want to hear a story?
Yeah, please.
Yeah.
Please.
When the sampling came into play.
Right.
And
right.
Pop was like, man, them got them motherfuckers. I can cuss right up to them motherfuckers sampling everything. Ain't nobody playing no music no more. They sampling my shit, everybody's shit. Throwing their shit, everybody's shit. I said, Pop, that's the way music is right now.
I don't want to hear that bullshit, son. Fuck them motherfuckers. Sampling my shit. I wish a motherfucker would sample my shit.
Mm.
If a nigga sample my shit, I'm going to fuck them. They better not ever sample my shit.
I said, Pop, you're going to be sampled one day.
Yeah, Eve already did it.
Hold on.
They better not sample my shit. Ever. Y'all been sampling shit. There ain't no more musicians out here, son. What we play at Thursday, son?
I said, Pop, we back down to Kilimanjaro again.
We got an out-of-town gig somewhere.
Where the fuck was it? I said, Pop, we in West Virginia.
All right, son. You go ahead out there, man. Do your thing, man. I'm going to get some sleep out of it, man. Dick so devil is hard to rap, but no way.
Whoa. Go back on that one. That went over my head.
You know he speaks fast sometimes.
Say that again.
No, I ain't gonna say that again. I'm gonna let that fly by there. They wanna see it again and they're gonna go report. Anyway. Anyway, years later, right?
Word. Right.
When Nelly and Eve sampled the shit,
right,
and Pop getting that money, I said, Pop, remember you told me that you ain't with nobody sample your shit?
I was lying, so.
Word. That's some real shit for you.
Pop say, Pop hit me like, I said, Pop, you remember back in the day in the apartment, you told me
that nobody ever sampled my shit. Nobody ever sampled my shit.
I said, Pop, remember you told me that back then?
I know, son. I was lying.
I guess you was lying.
Yeah.
Nelly is getting hot in here.
Yeah.
And Eve, right, blow your whistle, Jones.
Yeah.
Take your tambourines and blow.
Yep.
Yeah. Pop got a bag off both of them, Jones.
Yeah.
That's what it is, man. A lot of times I tell people, you know, stories about Pop, man. One thing about Chuck Brown, man, y'all realize, man, is I got to know Pop, man, on a very personal basis, man, where we were together every day, man, where, like I always tell everybody, I've been in like 78 countries, probably count, man, and the first person to take me out of this country was Chuck Brown at the age of 17, and I was so green and naive to the fact where when we were at Dallas going to London on the little transits to take you to the plane, I still remember to this day, man. We had Greg Boy, Greg Thomas, and Ben Cowan. We had Pete Van Horn. We had Glenn Ellis. We had Louis Oxley. We had a dynamite squad, Brandon Finley. And I'm on the transit going to the plane. And I said, Dad. I called him Dad. I ain't calling him Pop. I called him Dad. Yeah, what's wrong, son? We gonna fly all the way over on this? I thought the transit was the plane.
Oh, Lord.
Greg Boyer would tell you the story to the States. Man, they lost their mind.
I know, they were
laughing at me, right? Falling. But at the same time, they thought it was so cute. Like, oh, I didn't know. That was my first time on an airplane.
You know what? It's interesting you said that because my first professional performance was at 17. Mm-hmm. I joined EU when I was 17. And my first Capitol Center show.
Wow.
Was at 17, Back to School Boogie.
Back to School Boogie?
Yeah.
Is that the joint you had the Reebok outfits on?
Everybody asked you. No. Reebok, that wasn't even out. We was in, I hate to say it, we was in Earth, Wind & Fire spandex.
Oh, you said the first go-go live?
Not go-go live. It was Back to School
Boogie.
Matter of fact.
Yeah, I forgot about the Back to School Boogie.
We did both because we did two shows there because it was with, actually we was with, remember the group Paris, Can't Let Go, and all that. It was Paris, us, Frankie Beverly. The first time I saw Frankie, and believe it or not, and Roger and Zap, it was us. it was EU, Frankie Beverly made Zap Band in Paris.
Cameo?
Were they on that show? We did do a show with Cameo. We did two shows with Cameo. We did the Stadium Armory with Cameo.
What up?
Ow. Yeah. Did that. That was the fastest.
But let's go back to the 17-year-old.
Yeah, 17-year-old. I was 17. 17-year-old. And it was interesting. Just like you said, it was a lifetime experience. I mean, everything was new. First time.
My thing is, look, Tony, let me enlighten everybody, but we ain't going to prolong this situation. See, it ties into this. This dude is one of the first dudes that influenced me. You know what I'm Jungle Boogie?
Man.
Because we used to practice downstairs, actually, in Yasuna, New Hampshire Avenue. And when they did Party Time and all that, Ula Tony was my first hero, besides Jungle Boogie, because Ula Tony, he might not remember it, I was like probably 15 at the moment. And I would come to him. Ula Tony used to brush me off. Yeah.
How was you, little dude?
Yeah, I was a little dude. But hold on. I'm going to keep it real with you, 100 with you.
Okay.
But you didn't brush me off because you brushed me off. You brushed me off because you had something else to do. You brushed me off, but let me get it together, though.
Okay, get it together.
You brushed me off like two times, right? So, one time, we were rehearsing after y'all happened to look in the room, and you seen me. That's when you was like, okay, let me get with this youngin'. You seen them motherfucking fireworks.
Uh-oh.
You seen them fireworks, like Go-Go Mickey, everybody seen them. Go-Go Bouncy, everybody seen them. You seen them motherfucking fireworks.
Okay.
That's when you decided, okay, let me go holler at youngin'.
Because
I was like, for real, at a young age, I failed a grade because I skipped school every day and went back to my house and had a, there we go, that's what I told him right there. Had a mirror in front of my house practicing shit like this. All this. You, my hero.
I remember playing this in the hallway like me and my buddy.
That's him, y'all. This right here, this is him. You caught his blow. Put your hands together. We got a legendary.
I remember playing these joints in the hallway, man. Ula Tony trying to, just me and my buddies, man. You know what I'm saying? Especially on that EU Freak. You was on that the EU Freak.
Yeah. Now, the second EU Freak.
Okay.
Smokey was on the very first one, that the original one. Then okay. we went back and did it again on the Go-Go, at the party.
That's you.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember trying to play this in the hallway, man. Me and Gerald Smith sitting down in 11-07. I'm trying to play these joints.
Now, let me give you a history lesson. This is the very first time that Kiss went. It wasn't even hip-hop, then it was just rap. Just called rap. That was the very first time Go-Go. And then after that, you had the Salt and Peppers, and you had the season plays and all that. But that was the very first time Go-Go came together.
Shorty Jeff, come here. Come here, Shorty Jeff.
Yeah, that's the history. Come here,
man.
Yeah, that's the history right here. We went there and got killed. We just went there, we heard the track.
Just right now, ladies and gentlemen, Go-Go History. You hear the song right now, Party Time, Ula Tony, and Go-Go, look, Shorty Tim.
Yeah. And, you know, he was on fire up in there. You know, we went there and did it, man.
So this song right here, Shorty Tim, describe the whole situation.
Well, the whole situation was, we met Spike Lee at the club 9:30. And Spike Lee said he wanted professional percussion. Real talk, real talk. I don't like getting on the mic and I'm gonna keep it real with y'all. It was never a thing about a whole group, but it was individuals of percussion. Me and Ula Tony went up in there under the signature of Ted Hopkins and Gregory Elliott and Sugar Bear.
Okay.
We went up there and laid it. We laid our percussions and we put a signature on Go-Go, which other groups came before us.
Mm-hmm.
Real talk. No, other groups came before us and going into the New York Earl.
Oh, okay.
Before the New York Earl.
Yeah. Okay.
But our signature at that time was the whole groove was changed.
Right.
So,
y'all changed.
For any definition of what's going on, I really want to say this while I'm on the mic. We really have to dignify and put a significance on what we need to do. We all have to get together and put one as one. When I say one as one, DC would never do anything different unless we do it together.
Wow.
All groups have to get together and say, the greatest percussionist, let's party. The greatest rhythm section, let's party. The greatest chorus and rhythm section, let's party. Let's show these folks in the world that we have more greater. It's not a business, it's love.
That's what I'm trying to do, baby.
And, let's get together.
So yeah, and that's what we took in there with Curtis. He met Curtis, but we went in there and we dropped them tracks, man.
Hey, Shorty Tim, my brother. See, y'all gotta realize something. Y'all might see him on my show. Hold on. Y'all might see Shorty Tim on my show. But me and his brother talk on the phone without this show.
Okay.
And I tell him I love him. He tells me he loves me. See, and that's another thing Go-Go gotta get to. Don't depend on the hobby conga hour for artists to come together and tell, you know, tell each other we love each other. Which is good, don't get me wrong. Everybody in here, get each other's number, man.
Man, you have to. You have to.
Seriously. Get each other's number, man. Because me and this man talk. Me and this man talk. Me and this man. Yo. What we doing?
You gotta bring that back. Bring it back.
I don't know what happened.
Bring it back.
It went out. Technical difficulties. Anyway, like I was saying, I'm going to bring a man on right now. This guy, Dwan Chapman.
This
dude right here is one of the top Go-Go supporters in the world right now.
Yeah.
This dude right here, man, he supports everybody.
So, yeah.
He knows his shit.
100.
And I love this dude right here, man. And this dude, man, who I'm great bring on to. Look, you know what we ain't do all night, y'all? And they probably mad.
What?
Wave to Germany. We didn't wave.
Oh. We got wave to Germany.
Every week, Hamburg, Germany. We sorry, man. We sorry. Oh, my God.
Wave to Germany. That's right.
They got like 70 people in that joint every week.
All right.
Hey. We see y'all, Steelers.
Love y'all.
We see y'all, Steelers, man. Yeah.
Germany in the house.
Oh, my God. We forgot. Ernest, that's your fault, though.
Yeah. So, I mean, we have a good time. Him.
They're going to fly us out there next year. But it's his fault, y'all.
Yeah.
So, I'll make it up to y'all.
Anyway, come on here. Come on. Put your hands together for my main, Juan Chapman. Look, this dude is one of the top supporters in Go-Go, man. Put your hands together for this dude. And he brought toys, man. Love this dude right here, man.
Yeah.
Talk to people, man.
Here's first. Yeah.
Hello, everyone. Just want to let y'all know it's all about peace and love here in the nation's capital. You got a great leader here in Heartbeat.
Yes, you do. Okay? Yes, you do.
The thing that's important is you all got to work together. You know what I'm saying?
Say that.
Take one genre of music and have a few. It takes all.
That's right.
You got to come to this table here and sit down and communicate and devise a plan, and you got to stick to it.
Yeah.
That's what it's about, working together. In the communities, all these things, you got great things happening. Heartbeat is a great leader, follow. Mm-hmm. But what's more important, what do you see? A great leader what? Develops other leaders. And that's what Heartbeat is doing.
Thank you, man.
All the time. He's developing other leaders. But something very impressed me so much yesterday.
Okay.
Of all the things that Heartbeat do, he's still with the craft. He's still teaching.
Yeah.
Doing those things. That's monumental.
Yeah.
What you guys did. Yeah. A few minutes ago, how you alluded to how when you were young and you saw Tony, things about his style, you were attracted to it. That's important. Young bucks watch y'all today, right now. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's always somebody watching you, and that's important. And hey, your way, hey, what God wants us to do is give back. It's little bit of time.
Right.
Don't cost it nothing.
That's right. Big time. Big time.
You go out here and watch, man, what you guys have done over years, and you continue to do. You've got other young people out here that have aspirations to do what you do. Man, that should make you guys feel good about what you've done.
I'm glad you said that.
That's important. You know what I'm saying? Ernest L. here, great things in the community. You know what I'm saying? Well, they always say, what? A man's word is his bond. Your character is what define you. Out in the streets, man, you mention you guys' name, second to none.
Exactly.
Appreciate you. Keep doing what you're doing. Keep supporting the Go-Go family. Heartbeat's the leader. Keep following, baby.
Let me say this, man. I'm glad that you had a second on the mic, because every word you said, without you even saying it, you exemplify every day. Whether it be Facebook or whether it be at one of the gigs or something like that, you exemplify everything you just said. And it wasn't just talk, because I'm one of those people who mouth say anything, behavior don't lie. Okay?
Word.
You know what I'm saying? And his behavior exemplified every word he just said. And I'm living proof. I've seen it. He does it every time. So I'm glad you gave me the mic. He's able to express.
And he brought toys, too. So.
Yeah.
That's how he do, man. Hey, look, man. 8:10 p.m. each and every Tuesday. Name of Hobby Conga out, man. We cranking this EU right now, man. Look, it's a Hobby Conga out, man. I don't know what else to say, man. We going to give DJ Main like 5 more minutes, man. Crank this thing out, man. I'll be right back after these messages on Hobby Conga out, man. I don't know what else to do, man. I'm floored.
No. What you got for it, brother? That EU freeze and show please. Let's have a
We'll be right back. ways. Too good at getting away with all them games I play. Smooth walker, slick talker, anything I did. Get out of a jam quicker than MacGyver, you did. Shit, I think I'm sprung now. I seen a dude uptown who makes me want to settle down and have his fun now. He might be the one now. I can't explain it myself. I let my daddy check ground, give you the rundown.
Yeah.
Tonight, man, Toy Drive, toys just been dropped off, man. You know, God is good, man. We got my man, Pastor Q up in here, man.
Yes, sir.
Come around here, man. Give us a few words of encouragement. That's what it is, man. I'll be calling out each and every Tuesday night, 8-10 p.m. Eat Like Media.net. Powered by LiveMusicForYou.com. These dudes been giving me champagne all night, man. I don't know what's going on, man. Pastor Q, what it do, babe?
Hold on, I ain't even get
to join. Go ahead, do your thing. We'd like to thank Ernest L., my co-host, Bone Simmons, Ula Tony's in the building, man. My man Fish here, Dwan Chapman, man. You know, my 15, 14-year-old DJ. I don't know how old he is, for real.
Yeah, we got ID, man. We got to check his ID.
But we here, man. Look, great show tonight, man, ladies and gentlemen. You know what I'm saying? That's what it is.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. I'm so glad
let's guess to have a laugh or sing a song.
There you go.
Since we just get started, and before you know it,
comes the time we have to say
so long. Hey, everybody, look, hats off, heads bowed.
And let's go into a word of prayer, man. Mm-hmm. Praise God, man. Father God, we just thank you, Lord, for another day. Thank you for another opportunity. To be able to give you honor, glory, and praise this day. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father God, for all your things you're doing. Thank you, Lord, for all those that came in through and dropped through on the toy driver, Father God, to be a blessing. We know that you have blessed us to be a blessing, oh Lord. Thank you, oh Father God, for those who went into their finances and blessed. With the scripture teaches us, Lord, that it's better to give than to receive, oh Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, oh Father God. I pray that
yes,
you continue
Lord.
To bless this venue, bless this place here, Lord, the hobby through the Congo Isle, Father God. Thank you, Lord, that they became a vessel to be used to put smiles on kids' faces in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Let's go.
Man, the word I have for the day, man, came out of Ox, man. It was a little story when Peter and John had went up into the temple, and there was a man outside begging at the temple. And Peter and John said, man, silver and gold I have none. He says, but what I do have, that I give you. He said, in the name of Jesus Christ, rise up and walk, man. So the thing is, man, it's so amazing that a lot of people have their hand out wanting something, and the true thing, what they need is love. The Bible says God is love, man. And a lot of times we thinking that we need to give people. We think that the real gift is going to the mall and getting people gifted. The real gift is people need is love, man. People really need to see the love of God. Right. People really need to come together, man, and really just see the gifts that God has given us in showing love, man. So listen. Silver and gold I have none, but what I do have I give you, man. In the name of Jesus Christ, man. So, Lord, man, that was the word of God giving, man. I just pray to everybody just continue to be a blessing. All the toy drives, all the supports and things that you guys can do, man, to make a difference in somebody else's life. Because we all been blessed all year round, but some people haven't had an opportunity to be blessed. So be a blessing to somebody. Pastor Q, Cho, Disciple Christian Ministry. Mr. Will, preach for free. You guys be blessed.
There you go, man. Harvey Conger out, man, each and every Tuesday at 8, 10 p.m. ElikeMedia.net. Look, they got me champagned out, man. So, that's what it is, man. I love y'all, man. See y'all next Tuesday, man.
Love you back, man.
See y'all next Tuesday, man.
I'm so sorry I brushed you off when we was little, man.
Harvey Conger out, man. I'm gone. Let's go. DJ Mang, let's go.